What time is it? We're not talking about time on the clock, but what season is it? For our Roman Catholic friends and others, it's Lent time, a time for sacrifice and confession. For our Jewish friends, it's a time to prepare for atonement, a time of meditation and confession again. For us as a church family, it's a call for revival that's been going on for a time of reflection and confession. During this same season, we face this horrific pandemic, Corona. Realize with me that only the Lord God can bring us out of this situation. He has a solution. I remind you, He is the one and only living Lord that we need to depend on. Today, we're going to take a look at Psalm 32. Turn in your Bible, if you would, and take a look with me at Psalm 32, a psalm of King David, a man after God's own heart, the Old Testament tells us. Even in the midst of all his flaws and grievous sin, he's a man after God's own heart. And he teaches us something very powerful in Psalm 32. As we begin, look at verses 3 and 4. When I kept silent, my bones waxed away. Through my groaning all day long, day and night, your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was sapped as in the heat of summer. When I do something wrong, when I sin, I try to justify myself as best as I can. Oh, my groanings. It's a heaviness. There's a dryness in my soul like the heat of summer. That's my experience. What's your experience in your walk with God? You may not struggle as I do, but I do struggle. The chaplain supervisor for us in Kansas City, Missouri, told us one day as he debriefed us after our all-night stay at the hospital that many of us had set ourselves up for failure. And that's what we do when we sin. Hopefully, when we realize that our strength is sapped by our silence to God, we will confess our sin to Him. In chapter 32, verses 5 and 6, we read this. Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not cover up my iniquity. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you will forgive me my guilt. It's tough to admit and acknowledge when we do wrong, when we go out of bounds, transgression. I found my own pride often gets in the way. However, as I confess my sins, I find that God, the living Lord, the loving Lord, covers my sins. In the Old Testament, that's one way that they use for telling us that we're forgiven. God forgives our sin, and He takes away our guilt. Remember that. Remember that. I have a dear, dear friend that I'm close to that worships with us. And often in the worship service, I'll see him bowing his head and thanking God. He is so grateful for his forgiveness when he acknowledges what is wrong in his life. I love to hear Gary McSpadden sing. And as he sings, I just take it all in. He has a ministry continually in the Branson area. I like to hear him sing, I'm forgiven, forgiven. I'm forgiven. That's what Jesus Christ promises to us if we come honestly to Him. And if we come and do not let ourselves get all dried out, holding it in. With that confession, with that purposeful decision that you and I make, we are surrounded by deliverance. We are surrounded by deliverance. In verse 6, we pick up the thought of the psalmist, 32. Therefore, let everyone who is godly pray to you while you may be found. Surely when the mighty waters rage, they will not reach us. You are my hiding place. You will protect me from troubles and surround me with songs of deliverance. Yes, songs of deliverance. You and I can reach out to God and find He is sufficient for the mighty waters, for the mighty storms that come our way. He will protect us. He will help us in all of our self-made troubles. That's not only true of the coronavirus, but all kinds of things that take place in our lives. Sin. King Solomon said as he built the temple and shared with God's people, there is no one who does not sin. The Apostle Paul says the same thing in his writings in Romans that you've just heard about. All have sinned and come short of God's glory, of God's design for us. He has a great, wonderful design for you and me. May we not turn it away. May we pray to Him. We will find Him. Our sin often separates us from God. Separates us from God. God says we will find Him if we seek Him honestly with all our heart. I like the wonderful story of Corrie Ten Boom, the Nazi prisoner, World War II. She wrote about the hiding place, as the psalmist said. She found that God, in all of her troubles, in all the things that were wrong in her confession, that God is the hiding place. Listen, you and I can find that to be true for ourselves, and He, like the old song says, He is able to deliver us and to hug us and to take care of us and help us day after day after day. When we are honest with God, no deceit, not being stubborn in our hearts and ways, we can find Him. We can claim what He offers for us. We so desperately need what God has to offer. And at this time, may we seek Him out. May Him find Him to be true. In Psalm 32, verse 8 and following, it says this, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you and watch over you. Do not be like the horse or the mule that does not understand. It must be controlled by a bit or a bridle. Many are the woes of the wicked, but the Lord's love, the Lord's unfailing love, there it is again, surrounds the person who trusts in Him. This is the kind of God, the one and only God. Then and only God, then is He going to listen to you and me. He promises here, the loving God, to instruct us in the right way, to teach us what we need to know, to counsel us, advise us day by day by day. He promises to watch over the way we should go. That's the kind of God we have. That's just what we need in these days. Spiritually, personally, that's the bottom line. We need His solution. We need to go to Him. Not only do we find a solution here, also rejoicing. The last verse of this great, great psalm, this great, great sixth stanza psalm says this, rejoice in the Lord and be glad, you righteous. Sing all you who are of upright heart. As you and I become right with God, hear me, as you and I become right with God, we become right because we have an honest confession of our sin. We become right with God because of God's great forgiveness and mercy. We can then rejoice. Today we have a song in worship, Rejoice, You Pure in Heart. we, like David, can find that to be so true in our lives and then be able to sing with joy. The very beginning of Psalm 32 shares that joy. Blessed is he whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is the person whose sin the Lord does not count against him, and in whose spirit is no deceit. We rejoice because of what God has done. Only God, only the living Lord, is the one we can depend on to get us through and to bring solutions and joy to our hearts. May you and I surrender to him. May you and I, as God's people, say amen, so be it. Please, for your sake, for God's sake, for what we're going through, may you read Psalm 32 and realize that we together need to come to him and find answers through him, and he will guide us in this terrible, terrible, terrible storm and ordeal. Thank you for being a part of this service.